In today's lecture of power system, we'll discuss about the per unit system. Now, what is per unit system? So, per unit system is defined as, you can say per unit is defined as the actual value upon base value. Now, the per unit value of any quantity is defined as the ratio of actual value of the quantity to the base value of the same quantity as a decimal. Now, what are the advantages of per unit system? What are the advantages of per unit system? Number one, the per unit data representation. Per unit data representation yields valuable relative magnitude information. So this is the advantage. The per unit data representation yields the valuable relative magnitude information. Second, in circuit analysis, of system containing transformers, of various transformation ratio is analyzed simply or say analyzed easily. Third one, the per unit system are ideal for the computerized analysis of complex power system problem. Fourth one, the ohmic value of impedances are referred to secondary, is different from the value as referred to primary however if
the base values are selected properly, the per unit impedances are same, per unit impedance is the same, on the two sides of transformer. So now we take one by one. Now what is the advantage of per unit data represents yields valuable relative information, magnitude information. With the help of this per unit system, we'll convert the data, the actual data, into per unit, and then we'll get the relative magnitude information. The second advantage is in the circuit analysis of system containing transformers of various transformation ratio is analyzed easily. The per unit system is ideal for computerized analysis of complex power system problem, and the most important is the ohmic value of impedances are referred to the secondary is different from the value as referred to primary. So if we take this into per unit system, however, if the base value are selected properly, the per unit impedances are same on the two sides of transformer, or we can say that if we take the impedances in per unit, then the impedance from the primary side or impedance from the secondary side, if we see the impedance from the primary side or if we see the impedance from secondary side, the both the per unit values will be the same. These are the major advantages of per unit system. Now we'll first go with the expression used in per unit system. First, the per unit system, once again I'll write here, per unit system, that is the actual value in any unit divided by the base or reference value in the same unit. Now first consider the first frame, consider first a single phase system . Let base volt ampere VA, this VA is the unit, volt ampere. The base voltage V base in volt, then the base current that is IB is equal to VAB, base oblique V base ampere. So in the first single phase system, we'll assume that VAB is the base volt ampere and VB is the base voltage, and then from these two expressions we'll derive the base current IB, which is VAB divided by VB. Same as base impedance that is ZB, this can be expressed as VB oblique IB. So this will be written as the value of IB. We can put this value here, so we will get VB square oblique VAB base, it will be in ohms. Same if the actual impedance is Z, if the actual impedance is Z ohms, then its per unit value is given by, the per unit value is given by Z PU is equal to Z is the actual value oblique Z base value. So this will be written as Z ohms multiplied by ZB. The value of ZB we can put from here, that is volt ampere base oblique V volt base square. So this will be the expression for the per unit value of impedance, that per unit actual value of the base value, and the expression of base will take from here. I'll erase this one. Now, for a practical power system, the base megavolt ampere will be MVA, MVA base, and base kilo volt will be KV base. Hence base current IB is equal to MVA base oblique KV base, or here we can say Zb will be 1000 multiplied by the kV base oblique IB. So this will be the kV base square oblique MVA base, or this can be also written as 1000 multiplied by kV base square oblique kVA base in ohms. Hence, the per unit impedance can be written as Z ohms multiplied by the MVA base oblique kV square base, or simply it can be written as Z ohms multiplied by kVA base oblique kV base square multiplied by 1000. So this is for the practical power system situation. Now there are one more expression used in the conversion of used in power per unit system, that is change in base. That is change in base. That is Z per unit nu is equal to Z per unit old multiplied by the MVA base nu divided by the MVA base old multiplied by kV base square old multiplied by the kV base square nu. This is used for the change when you want to change the base in per unit system. This expression can be used here. This is the per unit value nu is equal to per unit value of old multiplied by MVA base nu divided by MVA base old multiplied by kV base square old divided by the kV base square nu. These two are the major expressions which are used in the per unit system or when we analyze the circuit. So these expression can be helpful. Now we'll take one numerical so that you will clearly understand how the per unit system is being used. Let's take one example that a generator rated at 30 MVA, 11 kV has a reactance of 20%. Calculate its per unit reactance its coordinate rate can for a case of MVA and 10 kV.
So this is an example which we have to solve, that a generator rated 30 MVA 11 kV has a reactance of 20%, calculates its per unit reactance for a base of 50 MVA and 10 kV. So this is a numerical of change in base, where the expression of change in base is being utilized. Now, first we will take what exactly is being given. So, reactance per unit is given, that is 0.2, 20% per unit. Now, H per unit nu. So we have the expression of change in base. We have the expression of change in base, that is X PU old multiplied by MVA base old, MVA base nu divided by MVA base old multiplied by KV square base old multiplied by KV square base new. Now put the value from the example, will get the X PU new. So X PU old is 0.2. Now MVA base new. So in this example, what they want? They want to calculate its per unit reactance from the for a base of 50 MVA and 10 kV. So 50 MVA is the new base now. 50 MVA is the new base now, and old base. So a generator is rated 30 MVA 11 kV has reactance 20%. So this is the old MVA. Same as KV old is 11, KV new 10. So by solving this, we will get a result, that is XVU new is J0.4033 per unit. So this is an easy example, but with the help of this example, what we understand is that how the value is taken from the numerical and how to put into the expression, and especially this is a changing base type of numerical. Now one more numerical we have to solve. Given a schematic diagram of power system is given, so I'll draw over here. G1, it is a generator having star connected with solid earth. This is load, motor load. It is also having star connected and solid earth. This is transformer T1. This is transformer T2. It is having primary star connected with solid earth.
The secondary is star connected with solid earth. Transformer T1 is having primary star connected and the secondary is having delta connected. And this is the transmission line having reactance 50 ohm. So this is an schematic diagram of a power system. So what they want, that draw the right here. Draw the per unit reactance diagram for the power system.
Base KV,
that is to 20 kV.
Now, first we'll find out the per unit value of transmission line reaction. So, step by step, first turn right here, step 1, the reactions of transmission line. Now, so the reactance of we have to find out the reactance of transmission line. The actual value of the transmission line reactance is given. We have to find out the per unit value. So the per unit reactance of transmission line is given as actual reactance / base reactance. So the actual reactance is ohm, but we have to find out the base reactance. That is XV. Here we can write X. Now this base reactance we will find out from these two values. So from the previous expression we know that so the base kV is given, that is 220 in phase /100. So what we find out is 484 ohm. Now this value we will put here, we will get the per unit reactance, that is XPU will be the actual value, that is 50, divided by the base value, that is 484 ohm. So the value will be 0.1033 P. So this is, by this way we will find out the reactance of transmission line. For unit reactance of transmission, as the reactance is given in, the actual value is given. So actual value upon base value. Now first we have to find out the base value with the help of base MVA, base KV, and then after finding this value, we'll put this value into the experiment value expression and we'll get the solution. Now this is the step 1. Now I will erase and we'll go to the find out the reactance of transformer. This I have to write, so I'll write here. Now this step 2, reactance of the transformer T1. Reactance of the transformer T1. Now we have transformer T1 which is having 40 MVA, 33/220 kV voltage rating, and having a reactance of 15%. This reactance is having these, but this reactance is for the these MVA value and this KV value. But as we have changed, the actual value are now, we have to, these are the base values, these are the actual values, but we'll take these are the base values. So we have to use the change of base expression for finding out the reactance of the transformer. So what will be the expression? The expression is per unit mu, it is XPU old multiplied by MVA base mu oblique MVA base old multiplied by AB base square, sorry, old oblique AB base square new. Now what we knew in this expression that XPU old, XPU old is 0.15%, so we will write here XPU old is 0.15% per unit, MVA base old MVA base old, that is 40 MVA, and the MVA base new, MVA base new is 100 MVA. Now KV base old, KV base old is 33 KV, and KV base new we have to find it. KV base new we have to find it. So for finding this KV base new, we have to use this expression, that is base KV on LP side of transformer is equal to base KV on HT side multiplied by LT voltage rating divided by HT voltage rating. So base KV on LT side is equal to base KV on HT side multiplied by LT voltage rating and HT voltage rating. So by putting the value base KV on HT side, that is 220 KV, LT voltage rating, LT voltage rating is, LT voltage rating is 33 KV divided by HT voltage rating 220 KV, what we will get is 33 KV. So the new base KV, will be 33 KV. Now put the value in this expression. We'll get the XPU, new. So by putting the value, that is 0.15 MVA base new, MVA base new is 100, old 40, KV base new and old both are the same, so 33 square. What we will get is 0.375 PU. This is XPU new for transformer T1. So the XPU is 0.375 per unit for the transformer T1. same as we'll find out for the transformer T2. So the same method will be adopted, and I write down directly the answer for transformer T2. It should be XPU. The transformer T2, that is 0.5 per unit for transformer T2. The same method or same steps is being followed for when we calculating the reactance or per unit reactance for transformer T2, and we'll get this answer. Now step 3, per unit reactance for the generator. Reactance for the generator. So here the generator is having 40 MVA, 25 kV, and the subsynchronous reactance is 20%. So the change of base expression is being used here, that is XPU new is equal to XPU old multiplied by MVA base new of the MVA base old multiplied by KV base square old of the KV base square new. So what we are having, XPU. I'll write down here, that is what we have XPU old for the generator is 0.2 PU MVA base old. MVA old is 40 MVA. MVA base new is 100 MVA. And here the MVA base MVA 50 MVA. So I'll write down here for step 4. Step 4, this is for the motor. Same expression can be used. Only the changes will be, that is, MV old for motor is 200, new is 100, MKV old is 11, and the KV new will be 11 KV. So by putting this value, that is, for motor this is 0.3, for motor this is 0.3, then new 100, old 50, 11, so by the way we will get 0.6 per minute for the transformer. So this will be, sorry, load. So this is for the motor load. By this way, we will calculate the per unit reactance of generator, transformer T1, transmission line, transformer T2, and motor. Now we have to draw the reactance diagram. Reactance diagram of this particular. So the first we'll draw the generator. This is for the generator reactance diagram. Is generator reactance diagram 0.287 per unit. Then we'll go to transformer T1. The reactance is 0.375 per unit. Then the transmission line. Transmission line it is 0.1033. Then transformer T2. Transformer T2 it is 0.5 per unit. Then motor. It is 0.6 per unit. This is E. So this will be the complete solution of this example. So this will be the per unit reactance diagram of this power system. So what is the advantage of drawing the per unit reactance diagram? Advantage is, now we can easily analyze the system, entire system. These are the reactances. We can easily analyze it as they are in series, so you can find out the losses at any place with the help of the reactance diagram easily.